Welcome back, everyone. If you're thinking about adopting a furry friend this winter, we met a few adorable animals looking for their forever homes this week, and Larissa's here to remind us about all of them.
Yes, there are so many wonderful animals that still need a home. And if you remember, we started this week with Jessie.
Yes.
Beautiful girl. She was a lab shepherd mix. I was in love with this girl. She's located here in Los Angeles.
Oh, my goodness.
With Wagging Tails Animal Rescue. She is majestic looking. And I had to get down on the floor with her because she
like
just wanted belly rubs.
That's right.
And then we had Willow the cat, who was also majestic. She had that long hair. She was beautiful. A fluffy thing, looked way bigger than she was because it was just all that fluff. And she's available through Little Angels Project here in Agoura Hills. And they do wonderful work. And she was just a beauty.
In fact, Little Angels Project was here a couple times this week.
Yes, yes. Yeah. They also came and brought Archie. You can't forget Archie. Archie is the adorable puppy that is a spaniel chihuahua mix who's only 4 months old, who would love a lap to sit in, and that's basically all he wants. He was so sweet. Again, available through Little Angels Project in Agoura. There were four of them all together. They were being kept in a chicken coop by somebody who had an unwanted litter. And so spay and neuter, please, please, please. And we won't have as many animals looking for homes, but little Archie is still available.
Okay. He's a cutie. I'm just looking at all his footage of you, and I'm thinking to myself, Larissa has found her dream job, that is for sure.
I say it every day.
I know. And then we also had a couple dogs coming from Florida.
Yes, yes. Florida has a lot of great dogs. We started with Skipper, who is a Jack Russell mix. A lot of energy, but very, very sweet. He was available through Polka Dogs Rescue, and he loves water, as you can see there, and playing fetch, and would be best in a home with other dogs to run around with. He's in Winter Garden, Florida. And then we had Fisher, who I have to say is one of my favorites of this week. He was an English-Irish setter who was bred to be a hunting dog, and he failed at his hunting techniques, and they were actually going to put him down because of it.
That's
but he
crazy.
Is looking for a home. He is very playful, cannot go to a home with birds, though. That was the only note. No birds or chickens. He is in Palm City, Florida.
Well, I mean, that makes sense.
Yes.
He was trained, you know, trying to be a trained hunter, so.
Exactly, and he is at the Farm Dog Rescue. Yeah, definitely a good idea. No chickens.
And we can't forget about our kitties, too.
No, we had Spunky, who was very spunky, who the minute the camera came on, he jumped off the lap, and we lost Spunky. But he is available at homelesspets.net. That's at the Hope Animal Shelter in Houston, Texas. Very sweet tuxedo kitty that loves playing with toys, as you can see there. And then we had another kitty that loved toys, especially teaser toys.
Yeah.
This is RJ. He was available at the Santa Maria Valley Humane Society, but he was adopted. Yes, just yesterday he went home with his family, and so that was really, really exciting.
And we also have some great news about Mr. Anderson.
Yes, Mr. Anderson, the Muppet. I mean, I have a dog named Muppet.
Yes.
He looked like a Muppet as well, and he was that Cairn Terrier mix with the funny face, and he was so spunky and needed a family with lots of energy, and he was also adopted. So another happy tale to add to the story. He was here in Burbank, California, so it's all very exciting.
I mean, it's a great indication also of how quickly and how effective it is what you're doing here, what we're doing here at Home and Family every day. I mean, those two, RJ and Mr. Anderson.
Gone. Adopted. I know.
That's amazing. Gone in the best possible
way. And RJ was one of the long-term residents at the shelter.
Right, that's right.
So he'd been there for months. So I'm telling you, we've been working some magic, and it's
that number keeps creeping up. Now we got to talk about who we had on the show today.
Yes, we had amazing cats and dogs today.
Okay.
We started with Morgan. Morgan was so sweet, a little kitty, a tripod. She only has three legs, but she gets around perfectly fine. She was a very zen kitty cat. You know, I said when I was showcasing her that I love cats, but there was something really special about her. And she was is about 4 to 5 years old. She's in Central California with El Gato Villa. They're a wonderful rescue. They take in a lot of kitty cats, and she was just absolutely beautiful and was purring on my lap. A very, very cool kitty. And then we had Maggie Lawson, Hallmark Channel star, who we love. She's doing a lot of fantastic work as well with animals and rescuing animals. And she brought an animal that she had a very a fondness to, named Turtle.
Yeah.
Turtle was a Shih Tzu mix who came from a hoarding case up north. pretty sad state. Yeah. Matted, overly grown hair, just no tending to, a lot of neglect. But now he is doing fantastic. He's 8 years young, very calm boy, but his foster mom does tell me that he still likes playing with other dogs and going for long walks. So not as calm as he may have looked when he was sitting on this couch, but he can be found at dogsquad.org.
Can we just take a second here to applaud Larissa for, doing all the great work that she's doing.
Thank you. Not only
that, she remembered every one of the ones this week and went through them like they were her own little babies.
Thank you. I don't remember the human names.
I'm Cameron, and I'll be here all week. But thank you, Larissa.
I really appreciate that.
To see all the animals we feature every day, you know where to go. HallmarkChannel.com and Larissa's website as well, SavedByTheL.com. And coming up next, we have more from the family.